Hello students, in this video we are going to see a problem based on continuous time convolution. So here is the problem. So we have to convolve two signals given like this. One is the impulse response, which is h of t given as e raised to minus t u of t. And second signal is the input, which is x of t, is nothing but unit step function u of t. So h of t is a impulse response and x of t is the input signal. With the help of these two signals, we need to get an output by convolution formula. So we need to get a y of t, that is nothing but x of t convolved with h of t, and y of t is our output signal. The first thing is that we will plot the signals. So e raised to minus t u of t. Because of u of t, this signal will exist from 0 to infinity like this. So here it's the t axis, and we will get a signal like this. So at t equal to 0, it is having a value 1. So this signal we obtained is h of t. X of t is a unit step, so it is quite easy. That means it will have the value 1 from 0 to infinity like this. So these are the two signals given, and we need to find out a convolution to get a y of t. So the formula that we are going to use is this: y of t is integral x of tau into h of t minus tau into d tau. Limits will be from 0 to t. In the end, it is decided by the area which is common between them. So let's solve it. The first step we are going to do over here is replacing t by tau, and at the same time I will do one more step, that is time reversal of this or this. So I will consider a time reversal of h of tau. So we will get a signal like this. As we discussed earlier, we are going to consider this t axis as tau. So it will be like this, it's tau. And then this tau here, x of tau we are keeping as it is, and we are just taking a time reversal of h of tau. So x of tau as it is, so it will be like this. And h of minus tau will get like this. Now h of minus tau, if I compare with this, I'll come to know if I put t equal to 0 in this, I will get h of minus tau. So in other words, I can consider this phenomena or this particular case where shift is 0, t equal to 0. Why we are doing this? Because we will be getting a y of t at t equal to 0 here itself, where we can say no area is common between x of tau and h of t minus tau for t equal to 0. Hence, I can say y of t equal to 0 straight away. But the condition apply, that is only applicable when t equal to 0. So we are getting a first output for zero shifting like this. Moreover, what I will do now, I have reversed this. So I will delay this sequence first. Okay, and I will delay it by any amount t. So the resultant signals will look like this. This is x of tau. And I'm delaying this by t amount, so we will get a signal like this. This is equal to 1, and this is a shift which is t. So the sequence that I obtain over here is h of t minus tau, and since I have delayed this, so I need to notify somewhere, so I'll notify over here t less than 0. That means I have delayed this sequence by t. So here, once again, no area is common between these two signals, so that here also I can say y of t equal to 0. So what we have done till now, for zero shift we got output, for shift which is less than zero, for any number we got an output. Now only case left is delaying this by any amount t. So let's do it. Now what we are going to do, we are going to delay repeat. We are going to advance signal by t amount, so the resultant signal will look like this. So this is shift. Since we are advancing means what? T is greater than 0. And the signal that we obtain over here is h of t minus tau. So what we'll get over here? We'll get an area common between these two signals like this. And more importantly, what we are interested in knowing is what are the limits where the area is been formed. So since here some area is common, so we have y of t as integral. The integral limits will be decided by the limits of the area. So this is the area that we got. So here it is 0 and here it is t. So but obvious here it is 0 to t. And the value of x of tau is 1 only. But h of t minus tau, since h of tau is e raised to minus tau, hence I will get h of t minus tau as e raised to minus t minus tau d tau. So I will get this expression and solving this integral will result in e raised to minus t multiplied by e raised to tau d tau. So e raised to minus t can be taken out, and integral of e raised to tau is e raised to tau, and the limits are 0 to 1. So if I apply the limits, I will get e raised to minus t e raised to 1 minus e raised to 0. So solving this integral and simplifying, we will get e raised to minus t into e raised to tau, limit 0 to t. And if you solve, since e raised to minus t is a constant, I can take it out of an integral. E raised to tau integral is e raised to tau, limits are 0 to t. So if I apply the limits, we will get this expression, which further reduce, and we will get y of t as 1 minus e raised to minus t. And this is for t greater than 0. So now I'm having y of t, which is equal to 0 for t less than 0. This is equal to 0 for t equal to 0. And y of t is 1 minus e raised to minus t for t greater than 0. So using this information, we can plot y of t. So it's quite simple. For t less than 0, it is 0. For t equal to 0 is also 0. If I put t is minus infinity, I will get the value as 1. To get, repeat, if I put t as infinity, I will get e raised to minus infinity, which is 0, and 1 minus 0 is 1 only. What is the meaning of this? The meaning of this is that this is a limit we can have, and our signal will reach the value 1 when t is equal to infinity. So we will get a y of t like this. So this is a graph of y of t, which we obtain as a result of convolution of x of t and h of t. Thank you.